Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Deal?
Boing.
Welcome to the Acquia podcast, Drupal technology, community, and business.
Welcome to the Acquia podcast, Drupal technology, community, and business.
There's a module for that?
Of course there is.
So this is the Acquia podcast, and we are at DrupalCon Amsterdam. It's day one in real time. I don't know when you'll be watching this. We've just done the group photo. We've just seen Dries talk a lot about how to boost and reward contribution in the community. My guest is Kalpana Goel from Forum One. Mm-hmm. What's your title there? What do you do?
I'm a web developer at Forum One.
So what did you think about what Dries had to say today?
I thought there will be a beta release out today. I was pretty excited about that. And I knew he's going to talk about funding core developers during his keynote.
And so this idea of gamifying somehow the contributions, gamifying not in the sense of making it trivial, mm-hmm. but in rewarding companies and individuals for making contributions, that sounds like a promising idea to me. I mean, we've got Foursquare with the mayorships, and we've got these concepts in our day-to-day lives now with our smartphones. Do you think that's something that would motivate people to contribute more in Drupal?
I think it's going to motivate people and companies both. It may be a slow process, but it will be a study, and I feel like for a long term, it's going to be a good solution for funding core developers and also boosting companies to having their developers contribute more to the core and also contribute module. So it's a win-win situation for both developers and companies.
Kalpana.
Yes.
What's your first Drupal memory?
My first Drupal memory was at DrupalCon Chicago when I met Webchick at the opening reception party. In DrupalCon Chicago, it was in the museum, and I was waiting and waiting to talk to her. And she is, yes, definitely very, very popular person in Drupal community. So I waited and waited, and I waited for my turn. And then she spoke to me, and it was quite good. It was quite impressive, and I was very scared. I was tense. It was my first DrupalCon, and as she said during your keynote that, you know, how she was during her first DrupalCon, sitting in the corner, and that's how I was, shy, sitting in the corner with my laptop. I didn't want to talk to anyone. I didn't want to feel that, hey, she doesn't know anything, or she's totally noob person. So she quite made a good impression on me, a really good one, yes.
So you have an IT background.
Yes.
You studied computer science?
I did my bachelor's in science, but then I went to community college to learn programming.
And how did you discover Drupal?
So I was working at the White House, but that time we were using some third-party CMS, and nobody was happy with that CMS. So all of a sudden, my project manager starts saying, we are going to use Drupal. And that was the first time I ever heard about Drupal, and I said, okay. I will learn about Drupal, and it started slowly, and here I am today.
And what made you stay with it?
I love the community. More than code, I really loved the people I met in the community, and that's why I stayed in the community.
So as a developer and a community member, you've come a very, very long way. You're now a part of not only writing Drupal core, mm-hmm. but teaching other people to contribute.
Yes.
Talk about getting more people into contribution. Talk about how that feels to have your patch downloaded 500,000 times a month.
It's a really great feeling. I feel like I did something for the community and open source. It's not just like I'm downloading Drupal and using for myself and for my company and for my project, but also I'm contributing to it. I have become part of it. And that's how I want other people to feel about it. And the feeling of nervousness and tension, it's just leave everything aside. Just step and take the baby steps, and you will cover a long way. You will be amazed.
What excites me about contribution especially is that code is kind of abstract. We grew up in front of our screens. We learned to code. Mm-hmm. And for a long time, it felt like I could manipulate the computer. I thought it was exciting that I could tell it to do something. But now, when we make web systems, when we that help citizen participation, for example, or that power the back end of apps, we're changing the real world.
Right.
So do you have any vision of where Drupal could go to make more real world changes now?
I think we are already making changes with Drupal. Even Drupal 8, we are making changes, like how many other systems we have adopted in Drupal 8, changing lives, so many mobile improvements. A lot of companies are attracting towards Drupal, and being in DC, a lot of government agencies have adopted from Cold Fusion Pages to Drupal. So that's a big evolution, I guess, in the web.
Is there a particular area of Drupal core that you have a special subsystem or something that you work on in particular?
Yes, I really like whiskey system, mm-hmm, in Drupal 8. And I try to do more because there is a history behind that. Do you want me to tell you?
Yes, tell us about the Web Services,
yes,
Initiative, a.k.a. Whiskey.
Yes. So Larry and other core initiative leaders did a podcast Shannon, last year in April, just before DrupalCon Portland. And I was watching that, and that was a live podcast. And other initiative leaders were also in IRC questioning or answering the questions anybody had. So Larry said that we are doing a lot of page conversions from Drupal 7 to Drupal 8, or the hook menu change to the new routing system in Drupal 8, and we need some help. And I asked him, how can I help? Because I don't know anything. And I don't even know what routing system you're talking about. And then he said, that's okay, we will help you. And he gave me some links, and he said, go read these links, and you will be amazed that you know so much, and then you can start helping us. And I said, okay. So I went back, and I read all those links he gave, and I said, okay, I know, and I can look at some examples, and I can get up to speed. So, and then I went to DrupalCon Portland, and I met Larry in person, and he helped me a lot. And I was amazed that being such a hardcore developer, talking to a person like me, that was amazing. And he actually sat down with me, and he explained me what the routing system is, how it works in Drupal 8, and other cool stuff. So, and that's how I stayed with Whiskey Initiative until now.
Nice. Drupal is, Larry did send you links to read, right? But Drupal has this incredible culture of, I know this cool thing, let me explain this cool thing to you, because then you can do it too.
Mm-hmm.
I love that.
Right.
So what are you most excited about in Drupal 8?
Most excited, of course, with the web services, but CMI is my favorite one, and also multilingual.
You work at Forum One.
Yes.
Which is a Drupal agency that specializes in government, NGO sort of projects.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at Drupal 8, let's say CMI and multilingual, how is Drupal 8 going to benefit you in your job, in your day-to-day working as a developer at this agency?
Another thing I want to bring it to this is headless Drupal. So we are, as Forum One, we use WordPress, we use, of course, Drupal, but adopting headless Drupal, we can use another technology with Drupal. So that we are very excited about. We can use Drupal as a backend and then AngularJS as the front. So it gives us more room to explore and grow as a company-wide, and also for the developers. So it's not, it's going back to the Larry's saying that, get off the island. So slowly we are moving towards that. So we are not limiting ourselves just for the Drupal, but adopting other technologies outside Drupal world.
So the loose coupling that allows you to use the Drupal backend with any front end of your choice is actually great, because Drupal is great at content management. And I've never heard very many people say in the past that Drupal had a great front end and a great theming system. Maybe now with Twig. Mm-hmm. But Drupal's great at managing content. Mm-hmm. So you think that your agency is going to take advantage of this and manage that content, but then explore new options?
I cannot say for sure, but I hope so. Everybody is pretty excited about this headless Drupal, and we have often talked about it. So my guess is yes, probably yes, for sure.
Can you see with features like CMI that you'll be able to work more efficiently, maybe deliver client projects faster?
I think so. We use features heavily right now in our current projects on Drupal 7. Everybody's pretty excited about CMI because it seems like very clean migration or actually deployment of the content and the configuration. So since we rely heavily on features, it's going to make a big impact on us.
Right, and that's a logical next step.
Yes.
For everyone playing along at home, CMI is the change in Drupal 8 that has put configuration into files, which lets us export them, version control them, and move them between different Drupal instances and still have everything. Instead of the old system, which we called write down your deployment notes on a napkin and click through them in the browser again, now we do it in code. It's true.
Yes, it is true.
Right? You know, before features, what did you do?
Yes.
What benefits for your clients do you see coming with Drupal 8?
So Drupal 8 is using variety of components from Symfony and REST API or REST Web Services, Twig. So that gives an opportunity for any company to let their developers to, you know, get the knowledge and get familiar with the different components. And then you bring your expertise to the client to, you know, solve their problems. And I think it's more robust and solid that you are not limiting yourself just to Drupal, but the different area of technologies.
Describe Drupal in one word.
Awesome community.
Wait, that's two words. Awesome community with a hyphen and then it's okay.
It's one word. Awesome.
What's your favorite Drupal superpower?
Community.
What's the answer to the ultimate question?
Drupal.
What question should I have asked you that I haven't asked you so far?
You asked everything.
I asked all the things?
Yes.
Okay. Hey, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For taking the time to talk with me. And thank you so much for your contributions and for teaching others to contribute too.
Thank you. Done.
So we have to make a deal.